Hey, thanks for tuning in. This is a new web series I'm starting called Rust Devlogs. We'll start this off with a server application, a GraphQL API made in Rust connected to a PostgreSQL database with DieselRS. I did some work off screen, so this is the database structure and I generated the Diesel schema with the Diesel print schema command, and this is how it looks like. And for the overall application, I followed Ian Wilson's blog post, Building Powerful GraphQL Servers with Rust. That's all you need to know, I think, so let's start the tape. All right, let's go. I'm stoked. Okay, the problem is I have no idea what's going on with this code.
Let's run. So I should get a lot of errors for our previous errors. Yeah, because of this like nullable shit. And I don't know what's going on with it.
So we've got like multiple nullable strings, but the problem is they need to be nullable. This wraps another SQL type to indicate that it can be null. By default, all values are assumed to be not null. Okay, yeah, that's true. But I have some values that may be null. I mean, I can't have it not nullable. That's not an option. Like, it must be able to be null, because there are certain fields which will be null.
Maybe it needs to be like, here he said it needs to be an option. Let's make all of these options option.
Oh, okay, because these are options, I can't use a string. Okay, that makes sense. I make a match right here, and if there's some value I want to return that, otherwise none,
empty string.
Okay, do I get any warnings?
No.
The trait bound is not satisfied. Yeah, but like, what the hell is that trait bound? What's this?
Okay, how can I format this file? Guess I have to do that manually.
Okay, so that's apparently what I expect. This is what I expect right here. Okay. And this seems to be what actually is delivered with Diesel.
Okay, there's one more, I think. There are a lot more.
That could be one of the problems, that I have more columns in my table than I'm having in my struct. But what would those be?
Pub description string, and here pub WhatsApp. What the hell? WhatsApp? Okay. And that should be an I32. I don't know. Okay.
Oh yeah, that's true. Yeah, how would I go about that? Like, I think I don't need to use an enum. I think I just did because it was in tutorials and it looked cool. But I don't think I can incorporate enums into my database. So I guess I just have it as a string, I guess.
All right, let's run this again. Yeah, I should comment this out.
From SQL, big int is not implemented for I32. Okay, so I guess the file type big int in Postgres doesn't translate into an I32. What's a big int? I64, all right, okay. So I gotta use an I64 probably. That's not a problem. I64. Okay. The trait GraphQL type is not implemented for I64. That's a bummer, but I must be able to print out I64 integers with GraphQL. Yeah, that could work. Though I have to change the data type in the database for that. That's not a problem though. Let's test this again. Where do I use big int though? Oh, because int 8 is a big int. Now I need to find out what's a normal int.
Okay, it's just integer. Okay. Integer.
Let's see. Okay, a lot of warnings.
Okay. Wait, if this works, I'm so happy. I don't think it does, because something else will definitely go wrong.
Yeah,
graphical. Okay, docs, query root, companies. Okay, let's do query, of course. I need to query, then companies, and then I want the name. Oh my god. This is so cool. I really didn't think this would work. Category. Nice. Okay. That's the first step. The first step to success. Now I need to do that for all of these tables. Well, not really, but I need to do all the joins and at least this table here, and all the other tables are for joins in between that. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, I'm streaming more Rust development on Monday, Tuesday and Thursday on Twitch. So see you there. Everything is linked in the description, by the way, including the GitHub repository of this project. Click here if you want to see the next devlog, and click here if you want to see a video that YouTube thinks you really enjoy.